This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Westlake is a residential and commercial neighborhood in central Los Angeles, California. It was developed in the 1920s, but many of its elegant mansions have been turned into apartments, and many new multiple-occupancy buildings have been constructed. Westlake is a high-density area, with a young and heavily Latino population. In the second decade of the 21st century, it has a score of primary and secondary schools. Contents 1. Population 2. Geography 21. Location 22. Nearby communities 3. History 31. Early development 32. Oil exploitation 33. Proposed factory district 34. Notable construction 341. Residential 342. Other 35. Change 351. Economy and lifestyle 352. Housing 4. Transportation 5. Emergency services 51. Police 511. Division headquarters 512. Notable crimes 52. Fire service 521. Engine company 522. Notable fires 6. Existing historic places 61. Built as residences 62. Other 7. Notable businesses 8. Education 9. Notable residents 10. See also 11. References 12. External links. Population. The 2000 U.S. Census counted 108,839 residents in the 272-square-mile neighborhood, an average of 38,214 people per square mile, the second highest density of any community in Los Angeles County. After Koreatown in 2008, the city estimated that the population had increased to 117,756. It was estimated in 1993 that 85,000 people lived within a mile of the Alvarado, MacArthur Park Red Line Station, and that the density of this neighborhood rivaled that of Manhattan in New York City. Another report the same year said that at 147 people per acre, Westlake had four times the average density of Manhattan, and that the vast majority of units are occupied by more than one family. Firefighters often find babies sleeping in dresser drawers, and children in closets that serve as their bedrooms. Nevertheless, census takers found that the average household size of three people was about the same as the rest of the city. Renters occupied 949% of the housing units, and house or apartment owners just 51%. Heavily Latino, Westlake was considered not especially diverse. Ethnically, the breakdown was Latinos, 734%, Asians, 165%, whites, 45%, blacks, 39%, and others, 17%. Mexico, 368%, and El Salvador, 172%, were the most common places of birth for the 676% of the residents who were born abroad, a figure that was considered high compared to the city as a whole. The median age for residents was 27, considered young for both the city and the county. The median household income in 2008 dollars was $26,757, a low figure for Los Angeles, and a high percentage of households earned $20,000 or less. The percentages of never married men and women, 47% and 364%, respectively, were among the county's highest. The 2000 census found 5,325 families headed by single parents, a high rate for both the city and the county. There were 2,591 military veterans veterans in 2000, or 35%, a low figure for Los Angeles. These were the 10 neighborhoods or cities in Los Angeles County with the highest population densities, according to the 2000 census, with the population per square mile. Koreatown, Los Angeles, 42,611. Westlake, Los Angeles, 38,214. East Hollywood, Los Angeles, 31,095. Pico Union, Los Angeles, 25,352. Maywood, California, 23,638. Harvard Heights, Los Angeles, 23,473. Hollywood, Los Angeles, 22,193. Walnut Park, California, 22,028. Palms, Los Angeles, 21,870. Adams Normandy, Los Angeles, 21,848. Geography. Location. Westlake is flanked by Silver Lake to the north, Echo Park to the northeast and east, Downtown to the southeast, Pico Union to the south and southwest, and Koreatown to the west. Westlake touches East Hollywood on the northwest. The street boundaries on mapping LA are the Hollywood Freeway on the north, Glendale Boulevard and 2nd Street on the east, Beaudry Avenue and the Harbor Freeway on the southeast, West Olympic Boulevard on the southeast and south, Westmoreland Avenue, Wilshire Place and Virgil Avenue on the west, and Temple Street in Hoover Street on the northwest. The boundaries of the Westlake Community Plan of Los Angeles City are Temple Street on the northeast, the Harbor Freeway on the southeast, the Santa Monica Freeway on the south, Washington Boulevard on the southwest, and an irregular line that includes Hoover Street on the west. Nearby communities. Relation of Westlake to other communities: East Hollywood, Silver Lake, Echo Park, Koreatown, Downtown. First to rise in the rolling hills west of the more settled and built-up part of the town, looking southeast along Wilshire from Lafayette Park. 1945, one of the first areas of Los Angeles west of Figueroa Street to see residential development. Westlake came to have a significant Jewish population. Wealthy businessmen commuted to downtown, Wilshire Center, now Koreatown, Hollywood, and the Miracle Mile from the district's Spanish Revival and Art Deco mansions around the 1940s. The district's northwestern blocks fringed the home of Los Angeles' early working-class Filipino population, who were shifted from what is today Little Tokyo and Bunker Hill, some of which remain in parts of Westlake and nearby neighborhoods like Echo Park, Silver Lake, and East Hollywood. Citation needed. Oil exploitation. In 1899, newly drilled oil wells in the area, with their unsightly derricks, were said to cause pollution and runoff in the streets at every hard rain, and residents of the neighborhood were indignant that nothing was done for their relief. The city had declared a 1,600-foot zone around Westlake Park where drilling was forbidden, later modified to 1,000 feet, but the legality of that ordinance was under attack by oilmen such as Wee de Groot. Even city attorney Walter F. Haas thought the law was invalid, although he had to defend it as part of his duty nevertheless. A superior court judge, in the case of People v. Richard Green and others, held the city law to be valid by 1900. However, it was found that oil production in Westlake had been, in effect, pumped dry, and the situation ceased to make news. Proposed factory district residents were alarmed in May 1919 by a petition being circulated by entrepreneur Arthur Evans to build a high-class six-story building on the southwest corner of Westlake Avenue and Orange Street for the manufacture of women's apparel, supposedly having the backing of 85% of property owners adjoining the site in the affected Lazard Tract. The promoters said they wanted to build in the Lakewood District because they could not get the kind of women workers they sought if they built in the city's industrial district, with its associated smoke and dust. They promised the employment of 1,000 workers, mostly women, as well as a school to teach the finer grades of needlework and a permanent exhibition space devoted to showing how garments are made. A mammoth petition of protest was presented to a city council committee on June 12 by a throng of opponents, and the applicant, identified in the Brownstein Lewis Company, withdrew the plan and never resubmitted it. Notable construction. Residential sketch of apartment building on the northwest corner of 6th and Lake, 1915. It later became the Hotel Ansonia Hotel. 1901, a five-story hotel was planned for the southeastern corner of 6th and Alvarado, across from Westlake Park, with John Parkinson as the architect. There were to be 300 guest rooms, as well as public and private dining rooms, kitchen, ladies' billiard room, office, ball room, and the many business accessories of a first-class tourist hotel. Hotel, 1902. Ground was broken at 6th and San Joaquin, today's Lake Street, for a four-story hotel with mission architecture designed by Al Haley and George Black on the northwest corner, opposite the park. The house will be so arranged that all guests' rooms will be outside, and it will have hydraulic elevators, a ballroom with stage, and the usual billiard rooms, bathrooms, dining rooms, kitchens, and servants' quarters. For the latter, there will also be provided a separate, detached building that will contain 48 rooms. Apartment building, 1915. A seven-story structure at 6th and Lake was designed by John Parkinson for owner James H. Edmonds and featured a ladies' parlor, a billiard and card room, and a 40-by-70-foot ballroom. There were 32 four-room and 8 three-room suites. All bedrooms will be arranged for open beds instead of the customary wall beds. A refrigeration system designed to cool all the ice boxes in the various apartments from a central plant in the basement will be a feature. It later became the Hotel Ansonia Hotel Californian, 1925. The spacious hotel on the northwest corner of 6th and Bonnie Bray, with its baths and showers, double closets, and radio communications, was opened with elaborate entertainment and ceremonies on April 1st. A novel arrangements of doors can operate to divide the building into quarters, as an extra precaution against fires. The main lobby itself is done in antique wood effect, polychromed and picked in with dulled off primary colors, and carefully highlighted with gold leaf. The fixture are hand-wrought ornamental iron, while beautiful tapestries and pictures on the walls add the finishing touches. The hotel was destroyed by fire in 1961. See notable fires below Hotel Arcady and Wilshire Royale. 1927. The 12-story hotel was launched in January 1927 on the northeast corner of Wilshire and Rampart Boulevards at a cost of $225 million, of which bonds of $1,325 million were purchased by S.W. Strauss & Company, designed by architects Walter. 2015 by M. West Holdings for $325 million in 2015 apartment project. 2010 the MacArthur Park, Metro Apartments, a $45 million joint venture between Metro and the Los Angeles Housing Partnership, among others, broke ground. It was to include affordable housing units and some 30,000 square feet of retail space. Other Masonic California Grand Master Benjamin F. Bledsoe foreground, with the cornerstone for a new lodge building in 1913, as William R. Hervey and Champ S. Vance Watch Masonic Lodge. 1914 Oliver F. Dennis and Henry Harwood Hewitt were the architects for a $30,000 building erected on the southwest corner of 8th and Burlington by the Westlake Masonic Association, with the ground floor given over to space for 7 or 8 retail shops and the second floor for the lodge headquarters. Lodge Hall finished in Philippine mahogany and Banquet Hall finished in white enamel. Elks Lodge. 1924 plans for a magnificent, $15 million 7-story Elks Lodge on the southwest corner of 6th and Parkview Streets, with an entrance on Carondelet Street, were announced in March 1924. It was to consist of a lodge room with seating capacity for 1,500 people, a ballroom with a stage area for presentations, and a gymnasium on the fourth floor were to be a grill, billiard and card rooms, 7 private dining rooms, directors' rooms and a band and glee club hall. There were to be 175 hotel rooms, and in the basement were planned 6 bowling alleys and a swimming pool. There was a 350-car garage with 10 handball courts on the roof. 2 roof gardens were planned. Architects were Curlett. Refugees from Mexico, El Salvador, Guatemala and other Latin American countries. It was said that trepidation, or fear, was the price of living and working in the Westlake District. People lived on the underground economy, strictly cash, and the district was infested with some of the city's largest and most menacing street gangs, with police and residents complaining of drug dealing, prostitution, thievery and extortion. Yet there was an air of economic energy and potential, with the vast majority of the residents just wanting to make an honest living. Just 17 years later, though, crime had dropped and Westlake was on a road to gentrification as rentals and property values in downtown Los Angeles and nearby Koreatown rose. Artists and other creative people moved into Westlake. Swanky nightclubs, organic tamale co-ops and art galleries followed. The change was traced to intensive anti-crime and cleanup efforts in MacArthur Park, particularly since the installation of surveillance cameras in 2004. A business improvement district was formed in January 2012. The city launched a campaign under a new city ordinance dealing with illegal street vendors throughout Los Angeles, but with principal effect in Westlake and the Venice neighborhood. The ordinance outlawed the sale of items with utilitarian value, like socks and t-shirts, but allowed vendors to sell art objects. A city-sponsored weekend market was set up, which required vendors to undergo training and licensing. Housing. Everyone knows the area suffers from overcrowded housing conditions and absentee landlords. Fire Inspection Task Force and a computerized record-keeping system were stalled, but fire officials said that budget constraints and the city bureaucracy thwarted their plans nevertheless. In that year, an appeals court said that a trial could go ahead against Highland Federal Bank, even though it was not an actual owner. It was accused of operating a network of slum buildings in Los Angeles, for one of which, the Cameo Hotel at 504 South Bonnie Bray Street in Westlake, the owner was listed as Tellus Black, a Labrador Retriever. That decision set a statewide precedent. Authorities alleged the bank knowingly helped finance purchases in Westlake, Echo Park, Hollywood, South Central, Koreatown and Pico Union by buyers who had no means and no intention of keeping the structures in repair. Slum conditions were cleaned up after the suit was filed, and, in a 1996 settlement, the bank agreed to pay $14 million to tenants, to the city and to public interest attorneys. In 1999 a judge sentenced another landlord to live in a room on the fifth floor of the man's 6-story, 96 unit building at 744 South Beacon Avenue. The owner had to remain there from 7 p.m. until 7 a.m. for 45 consecutive days. During the other hours he was allowed to supervise repairs to the building. The landlord had been found guilty of 12 code violations, including broken fire doors, fire escape drop ladders that did not work, blocked fire sprinkler controls, broken windows, broken and missing smoke detectors and exposed live electrical wiring. He had to pay $1,774 in fines and performed perform 100 hours of community service. Other legal action followed against other slum building owners. Transportation station sign for Metro Underground. 2015 public transportation in Westlake was first proposed in 1887 by railroad entrepreneurs Herman Silver and J.F. Crank as a double-track street cable railroad with the western terminus at 7th and Alvarado Streets and the eastern at the proposed Union Depot of the Atchison, Topeka and Santa Fe Railroad Company near the western extremity of the First Street Bridge, later amended to continue the road along First Street to Aliso Avenue and Chicago Street in return for the franchise. The two men offered to donate $10,000 to the city. The railway ran to the southeastern corner of Westlake Park. There is now a Westlake, MacArthur Park station of the Los Angeles County Metro Rail System, whose entrance is across Alvarado Street from MacArthur Park. Emergency Services Police Division Headquarters, Rampart Division, LAPD. 2008 Westlake is patrolled by the Rampart Division of the Los Angeles Police Department, 1401 West 6th Street at Valencia Street, within the Westlake neighborhood. Notable crimes. 1906 On August 16, 1906, Annie Sanderson, 45, was slashed to death by her husband, Edward H. Sanderson, president of the California Truck Company, in their residence at 1336 Westlake Avenue. He then committed suicide by cutting his throat with the same knife. Westlake crime. Front page of Los Angeles Herald for August 14, 1908. 1908 Wielding a sharpened axe, Henry J. Dufta, 56, slew his sleeping 24-year-old son, Fred Dufta, a machinist, in the Sun's bungalow at 247 North Mountain View Avenue on August 13, then walked uphill to nearby 453 North Westlake Avenue, where he used the same instrument to decapitate his pregnant daughter, Zita Lacombe. He returned to his home, where he cut his own throat, attempting suicide. He had previously purchased gravestones for himself and his two children, which had already been laid at Evergreen Cemetery. A jury trial resulted in a verdict of insanity. 1922 On February 2, the body of motion picture director William Desmond Taylor was found on the floor of the living room of his bungalow at 404 Alvarado Street. He had been shot. The killer was never found. 1948 Joyce Corbley, or Corbley, age given as either 22 or 38, died after shooting herself in the head on June 26 when she played a game of Russian roulette in a room at the Ansonia Apartments, 2205 West 6th Street. 1996 On March 29, Linda Morimoto, a noted physician of the Japanese-American community, was found bludgeoned to death on the floor of her ransacked home in the 400 block of Lafayette Park Place. No arrests were made. 2010 Two nights of violent protests troubled the Westlake neighborhood after a policeman fatally shot Manuel Jimines, a Guatemalan construction worker who spoke no English and very little Spanish, at 6th Street and Union Avenue on September 5. Police said Jimines had threatened a woman with a knife, which he refused to drop. 2010 The mummified remains of a stillborn baby and an infant, brother and sister, were discovered in August, wrapped in newspapers from the 1930s and hidden inside a trunk in the basement of an apartment building near MacArthur Park. They were identified as the children of Janet Mann Berry, who had lived in the building and who died in Canada at age 97 in 1994-2012. Pedro Martinez, a 26-year-old gang member, was sentenced to 100 years to life in prison for killing Andres Ordonez, 25, a church deacon who was trying to stop a woman from spray painting, or tagging, an outside wall at Iglesia Principe de Paz Church on Beverly Boulevard. Ordonez was slain on November 4, 2012, when he and a fellow parishioner exited the church to stop the woman's vandalism. Martinez stepped from a nearby vehicle and opened fire, killing one and wounding the other. Nearby residents said that gang members had threatened violence against those who complained about or painted over graffiti. The woman was arrested and faces trial. Fire Service Engine Company LAFD Rescue 11 on Alvarado Street, with sidewalk merchants in the background. 2015 LAFD Engine 11, with the Westlake Theater in the background. 2015 Los Angeles Fire Department Station 11 serves the area. In 1993 it was said to be one of the busiest fire stations in the country. Notable fires. Hotel Coronado, 1905 An early morning fire destroyed the massive and popular Hotel Coronado at 667 Coronado Street on December 4, 1905. After a delay in communicating by telephone with the fire department, the blaze spread rapidly, and more than 80 guests had to flee, some in their nightclothes. Sarah and Helen Mathewson were lessees of the hotel, which was owned by M.N. Russ Avery and Superior Judge Walter Bordwell. The tourist hotel was one of the most expensive in the city, being patronized by wealthy persons to whom the cost was not a consideration. By the time fire firefighters led by Chief Walter Lips arrived about an hour after the blaze was discovered. The hotel was already in ruins, and the men turned their efforts to saving nearby buildings close by were scores of mansions, some of them among the finest in the city. Sparks dropping on the dry roofs caused small blazes in many places. The occupants of the buildings in danger succeeded in extinguishing the blazing embers. The costly furnishings of a number of fine houses were removed to places of safety outside the zone of danger, and neighbors gave shelter to hotel guests who had fled. The Mathewson sisters were overcome by smoke, but they survived. Their pet dog died. Helen Mathewson later asserted charges of negligence against Chief Lips, which he denied. Hotel Californian, 1961-1994. Flames engulfed the upper two floors of the five-story Hotel Californian at 1907 West 6th Street on August 2, 1961. Firemen were threatened with injury when a water hydrant burst and a hose flailed about viciously before water was turned off. Scores of television aerials on the roof of the hotel hampered the men before the flames were brought under control. The hotel reopened, but became a classic slum building where a changing cast of owners suck out profits, fail to make repairs and leave tenants in miserable conditions. City officials closed its entrances with plywood and metal bars, but homeless people broke through and made it their home on November 21, 1994. It took 186 firefighters from three companies to quell a massive blaze that all but destroyed the place. Finally, the city council ordered the old hotel razed as an irreparable hazard. Burlington Avenue, 1993. Nine people, mostly immigrants from Latin America, and two fetuses died as a result of a fire that ravaged an apartment building at 330 Burlington Avenue on May 5. More than 40 were injured. Some residents escaped by jumping from, or, in the case of children, being thrown from upper floors into the arms of rescuers, but others died when they were trapped on stairways. Members of the 18th Street Gang joined in the rescue effort. More than 100 shock survivors were given emergency shelter in the Belmont High School gymnasium. It was the fourth deadliest fire in the city's history. Fire officials said the owners failed to correct a faulty alarm system. Amid other fire code violations, some fire doors had been illegally propped open. Church of the Immaculate Conception in Westlake. 400 mourners were at a special eulogy at the Church of the Immaculate Conception on 9th Street, later James M. Wood Boulevard in Westlake, where Cardinal Roger M. Mahoney called upon city authorities to work toward improving apartment safety. Among the mourners were elementary school classmates of two of the dead children and a fire department honor guard of about two dozen firefighters, dressed in formal black uniforms in all. The caskets at the funeral mass contained the remains of 11, including three mothers, two of them pregnant, two fetuses and six children. The two fetuses were placed with their mothers in the caskets. A 15-month-old child of Guatemalan parents was buried earlier in Calvary Cemetery. The other remains were returned to Mexico and Guatemala. McKinley House, 1994. After years of neglect and controversy, this boarded-up historic monument at 3rd Street and Lafayette Park Place finally succumbed when flames took the remains of what had been an elegant Italian Renaissance-style home overlooking Rampart Boulevard. Two transients were found dead when firemen were able to inspect the ruins. The 20-room house was built in 1915 by an Ohio millionaire who lived in it during the winter. Other families had it, too, until mortuary owner Mater McKinley bought it in 1945. He died in 1970, and his widow, Vari Comp McKinley, lived there until her death in the mid-1980s. In 1987, developers purchased it with the intent of raising a 118-unit apartment complex on it at the prodding of the Los Angeles Conservancy. The city declared it to be a cultural historic monument. Rod and Sherry Daniels, intrigued by the idea of owning the beautiful old structure, bought it for $1 with the intention of moving it to Chatsworth in the San Fernando Valley. Over 6 years, those plans stagnated and the property kept deteriorating until the 1994 blaze put an end to the Daniels' dream and the house as a historic structure. Neighborhood residents launched a drive to turn the rubble-strewn lot into a neighborhood park. Today the site is home to a privately owned school called the Lafayette Park Primary Center. Existing historic places: Victorian House at 826 South Coronado Street, 2012. Mary Andrews Clark Memorial Home, 2008. Westlake Theater Building, 2014. Young's Market, Company Building, 2008. Built as residences. 757-767 Garland Avenue, Queen Anne Mansion for Executive Charles the 150th Leslie. 826 South Coronado Street Residence. David J. Whitmer Family Houses and Compound, 1422 West 2nd Street and 208-210 1/2 Whitmer Street. Frederick Mitchell Moore's House, 800 118 South Bonnie Bray Street, named for its owner, who discovered the Yellow Aster gold mine after years of prospecting in the Mojave Dayer Greary Musser House, 403 South Bonnie Bray Street, Lewis House, 1425 Miramar Street, is a Queen Anne-style Victorian built in 1889 and attributed to Joseph Cather Newsom Mary Andrews Clark Memorial Home, 306-336 South Loma Drive, is a large French colonial chateau-style structure built in 1913 as a YWCA home for young working women. In 1987 it was damaged by an earthquake and was sold in October 1995. It was reopened with 152 bachelor units as a home to single, low-income workers. Each floor has a communal kitchen and lounge, and shower enclosures were built into the hallways because most of the rooms have only half baths. Susanna Machado Bernard House and Barn, 845 Lake Street, Other Belmont Tunnel, Toluca Substation and Yard, 1304 West 2nd Street, Elks Lodge No. 99, Park Plaza Hotel, West 6th Street at Park View Street. Done in a neo-Gothic style, the building still sports a brass sculpture of a set of elk antlers embedded in the clock above the entry. The Elks sold the building because of shrinking attendance, and it is now a luxury hotel. Felipe de Neve Branch Library, 2820 West 6th Street, Filipino Christian Church, 301 North Union Avenue, First Congregational Church of Los Angeles, 540 South Commonwealth Avenue, designed by Allison Mother Trust. Superette Center, 2506-2522 West 3rd Street. Park, Wilshire Building, 2424 Wilshire Boulevard, built in 1923, designed by Clarence H. Russell and Norman W. Alpa. Westlake Theater, 634 South Alvarado Street, Wilshire. Westlake Professional Building, 2001-2015 Wilshire Boulevard, 639 South Westlake Avenue. Young's Market, Company Building, 1610 West 7th Street, built in the 1920s as a market and office building, with marble columns and terracotta frieze, converted into lofts. Notable businesses: the first original Tommy's Hamburgers on the corner of Beverly and Rampart, Ruth St. Denis and Ted Shawn, 1916. The Mexican fast food chain El Pollo Loco opened its first restaurant in the United States in Westlake. Langer's Delicatessen was an iconic presence on the southeast corner of 7th and Alvarado Streets, which intersection was in 2008 officially named Langer's Square by the city. The Jewish Deli was founded by Al Langer in 1947 when the neighborhood had a large number of Jewish residents. Original Tommy's was opened on May 15, 1946, by Tom Kolix, the son of Greek immigrants, on the northeast corner of Beverly and Rampart Boulevards. Ruth St. Denis and her husband, Ted Shawn, opened their dance studio, Denishawn, in 1915 at 6th Street and St. Paul Avenue in downtown Los Angeles, but moved in 1917 to a building fronting Westlake Park. The structure had been vacated by the Westlake School for Girls, which had been founded in the Westlake neighborhood in 1904. The school moved to Holmby Hills in 1927. The Westlake Theater was listed on the National Register of Historic Places in 2009. Opened in 1926, the theater had seating for 1,949 patrons and was used for both motion pictures and vaudeville shows. It is now used as a swap meet and is being renovated. Education: Esperanza Elementary School, Camino Nuevo Charter School. 1/8 of Westlake residents aged 25 and older had a four-year degree in 2000, a low rate for both the city and the county. The percentage of residents with less than a high school diploma was high for the county. Schools operating within the Westlake borders are New Village Charter High School, Charter, 147 North Occidental Boulevard, Camino Nuevo Charter Academy, Charter, 3500 West Temple Street. Soledad Enrichment Action Charter High School, Charter, 222 North Virgil Avenue, Los Angeles School of Global Studies, LAUSD Secondary, 322 Lucas Avenue, Harold McAllister High School, LAUSD, 611 South Carondelet Street, Los Angeles Academy of Arts. Equitas Academy Charter School, 631 South Commonwealth Avenue. MacArthur Park, Primary Center, LAUSD Elementary, 2300 West 7th Street. Hoover Street, Elementary School, LAUSD, 2726 Francis Avenue, Esperanza Elementary School, LAUSD, 680 Little Street, East Manfred Evans Community Adult School, LAUSD, 717 North Figueroa Street, Immaculate Conception School, Private Elementary, 830 Green Avenue, notable residents Edward Fallis Spence, about 1892 Denicio Bottiller, member of the Los Angeles Common Council and city auditor Matthew Cook, filmmaker Steve Downs, radio disc jockey Elisha K. Green, member of the Los Angeles Common Council and entrepreneur Harrison Gray Otis, publishing executive Hiram Sinsabaugh, minister, banker and member of the Los Angeles Common Council Edward Fallis Spence, entrepreneur and mayor of Los Angeles. See also historic Filipino town, Los Angeles, referred to as the Northern Edge of Westlake. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Westlake, Los Angeles. Los Angeles portal references. Access to many links may require the use of a library card. Carat. Population density, mapping LA, Los Angeles Times 2009, retrieved June 14, 2016. Carat AB, Central LA, mapping LA, Los Angeles Times 2009, retrieved June 14, 2016. Los Angeles Times January 22, 1899 p. June 28, 1902 p. Carat monumental edifice in Westlake Park District to house Los Angeles Elks organization. Los Angeles Times March 9, 1924 subscription required help. Escaped the flames and smoke. Have few resources to start anew. Donors send help to Red Cross Emergency Shelter. Los Angeles Times P. Carat about Rampart Community Police Station. Los Angeles Police Department retrieved June 14, 2016. Carat physician found bludgeoned to death in her bedroom. Los Angeles Times March 30, 1996 P. Carat Campbell, Jerome March 20, 2015 gang member sentenced to 100 years to life in 2012 killing of church deacon. Los Angeles Times retrieved June 14, 2016. Landmark Hotel. Los Angeles Times retrieved June 14, 2016. City Planning October 2008.